Welcome, welcome, welcome to America the Ride Along. I know I just sprung this on you guys. It come up pretty quick and it went live pretty quick, but this is a real ultra stealthy camp here, boys. This is what you call urban warfare for camping. Now, I only got the one device, so some things are going to be a little sketchy. But we'll give it a couple of minutes and see if anybody comes in. And if anybody does, we're going to hang out for a little while. Oh, I'm going StreamYard this time. I didn't even think about it. Whatever. Let's see if I can get that branding on. All right, well, still fucking with it. Sorry, guys. I was looking for a couple of things. Overlays. Banners. Maybe that's what it was. There, I got that. Good evening, Grindel's Garage. Mike Miller, guys. I'm sorry. I had all kind of crazy crap up there in the way. Fucking around the stream yard there. So it took a moment. Sorry about that. We'll get this a little bit up. Yeah, we're going live. Urban stealth camping here. I'm still in the woods, but I'm in that patch of woods you find homeless people in. Although there's no homeless people in here. So it makes me think that I might bump into a popo here and there. But we're here. We made it, guys. We only got about 118 miles today before the skies literally opened up on me. What do we have from Grindel? What's up, brother? What's up, Jared? Evening, Grindel. Did you get your bike fixed? Yes, I got it fixed. I fixed it before I left Walmart. derailleur cable. It snapped. Snapped right at the derailleur. Eric Tennant. Hell yeah, dude, we are here. We're still in Louisiana, though, so I feel sketchy whenever I'm in Louisiana. You never know what's going to happen in Louisiana. Y'all think Florida's bad. Who knows what Louisiana? There's alligators. So ERT is here with us this evening. Thank you, ERT, for coming in. I don't know, is my volume okay? It's still raining on me right now, guys. I ain't gonna lie to you, but I'm in a little corner. I'm up underneath the pine tree. I got moths flying in front of me now. So we had a pretty good day. We stopped at the Bonnie and Clyde Ambush Museum. We found some donkeys pumping oil for the old gas bike. That's the first gas bike leaned up against one of those little donkeys. What else was there? Guys, I could not believe it. I jumped on the interstate today. We got about 20 miles down the interstate when I was it? It was from startup or something before I went up on the interstate and noticed. Good evening, Cecilia Ann. And noticed that cable was snapped. I'm like, what is it? So I pulled over real quick and I'm like, why won't this thing shift? And holy shit, the damn thing had broken off. And then y'all seen that my derailleur hanger was fucking floppity. I'm thinking there was a plastic washer right there that had eaten up a little bit of a gap there, maybe a 16th of an inch gap. And kept it from being a little bit rattly. So I ended up using a piece of cardboard. That's all I could find. I went in Walmart hoping to find some washers or something, and I'm sure I'll find something during tomorrow. But the rain had got on top of me, and thank you, Cecilia Ann. And it made me think about what I was doing and how quickly I needed to get things done and how I needed to go find somewhere to stay before I had run out of time. I'm also seriously in need of a goddamn safety meeting. I know I got my super orange shirt on. I'm supposed to have a super red shirt on right now, but I didn't get a chance, man. It started dumping one last time just before 8, guys. I mean, just the fucking skies opened up a little while ago again. And I'm like, God damn it. I found that umbrella over there at the little storage unit place there, and I got that up right now. Over all my gear. Over me, I got nothing but sunshine or nothing but rain clouds. Yep. And I didn't take time to clear the bowl. That light is fucking crazy bright in my eyes. What if I could put it from above? Nope, that didn't work at all. Let's see what that did. No better. That's gonna be better, I bet. Nope. A little bit more downward. Well, guys, I'm trying to figure out the goddamn lighting situation. They're right behind this fucking, my little camp right here is a goddamn street light. And I, hey, Dave, what's up? What's up, ERT? Latest 40 millimeter on the planet. Good afternoon. Yes, good afternoon. I was looking to set my damn light up, man. Just give me one second at it. Ooh, what about right there? That's a pretty good spot. That's got all kinds of angles. Oh, there we go. Good enough. I couldn't read the comments because the light was right in my goddamn eyes. Good vids today, Jared. Thank you, sir. Boy, I'm trying everything to fucking get the goddamn light on me. It's always like that. Fucking always like that. There, that's as good as it gets, and I can read the comments. I can't read the comments, it's too freaking bright. I got a glare off my eyes, guys. I had the walk of shame, tell the parking, the brother is dropped and picked me up. Oh no, he had to do the walk of shame, and instead of walking it, Mike Miller said, fuck that, called his brother, had him come pick him up. That's a good idea, guys. Keep a safety number on you, man, for that emergency ride. Christy is my emergency ride now out here in the middle of nowhere. No emergency rides, it's just emergencies. Just plain old emergencies. So yeah, we only did 118 today. Rain put a damper on everybody's fun, on my fun today. Bad cell connection yesterday. Oh, well, oh crap, Mike, that was a reason why I parked mine years ago. Nobody to call, no cell service. So yeah, that was my problem with today. Dave was, I have a note, and my neighbor will rescue me. That's good, Celia. It's good to have somebody. It's good to even know that you know someone that, you know, gives a shit about you and would worry about where you were at, how you were doing. So what else was there? We had a little breakdown and we fixed that. It was a good little emergency. It was all happy dappy and you know, but something about stopping for a little while at Walmart, man, made that fucking rain just. And I'd been running from it all day. My mom was like, "Oh, Jared, you're going right into it. Don't worry, Mom, I'm moving because I'm moving and it's moving. You can't predict where it's gonna rain at, and for how long." Well, the rain caught me right at 4:40 or 4:30. Oh, I think about 4 o'clock, and I don't know. It was after four. And stop me cold. I'm like, holy shit, man, I need an awning right now. I need it now. I'm not getting soaking fucking wet for nobody. And so I went across the street and found an awning and hung out there on that bench for, I don't know, about an hour waiting for the rain to break. And it finally broke. And then just before the fucking live, guys, it just opened up. I had to wrap everything up, get it all closed down, get it underneath this goddamn little umbrella. No fucking lights, no nothing, you know. Son of a bitch. That really pissed me off. Let me hit this thing. Jared is a wild man. I am a wild man for sure, dude. I was born wild. Born wild. But I'm just a crazy person. That's just the truth of it, Dave. I'm just a fucking crazy person, you know. I don't know what to say. I just want to do something, you know what I mean? I don't want to just do something. I just want to do something, you know, I don't know, do something different. Yeah, that's all I can really say about it. Just want to do something different. I got in the deep in the desert. And I'm not sure if anyone could help me. I needed it. Oh, I get so deep into the desert. I get Eric, that was a really good one. He says he gets so deep into the desert that at times he's so far away from main roads and services that he's not sure anyone could get to him and not sure that people would even, he's got no services, man. Although you would think with the mountains in Arizona and the desert that it'd only take one cell tower for the whole state. But no, it's not like that. Dude, I got them fucking mosquitoes. They're on my ass. They are sucking my ears dry right now. It's that goddamn light, and I know it. They're like, "Oh, follow the light to the bloodbath, to the blood bag." I'm just a blood bag to them. You know it. And Cecilia Ann had posted that on, I think it was a community post, or maybe it was a short video. I think it was just a short video on how whited out it was where she's at right now, and I was. It is so hot here, guys, right now. It's like 82 degrees or so at sunset. It is a muggy. I can't believe I'm this far north and I'm fucking muggy sweating. And I mean muggy sweating. I'm not exactly sure how loud I'm coming in on this. I stopped doing everything May 25th, 1996. That was quite a long time ago. They're on top of the food. They are the mosquitoes here, dude, in the south are definitely on the top of the food chain, dude. They kill, they get everybody. Ain't nobody too big for them. These sons of bitches are so vicious, they'll suck the blood out of a tick. So I've heard. Let me get some weed. Get some of my weed. Give me some weed. Please. All right. I know packing bowls is not the ideal thing to do sometimes. Sometimes joints and blunts and other things prefabbed are much better, but I couldn't even open the weed. It was a goddamn rainy out. What else was there? Went down some really cool country roads. Dave, did you check out the Bonnie and Clyde ambush? That motherfucker wouldn't let me in there to see that car. Dude, he wouldn't let me pull my use my phone inside of his little gift shop either. He's like, "That's for paying customers." I'm like, "All right, man, I'm buying some." I bought some postcards from him. I mean, come on, dude. Let me. But I understood. I wasn't gonna push him on it. And what else was there? So we stopped there. We stopped at a little oil pump. That little oil pump was just cute as shit. When I seen that thing, dude, I was like, "Oh, I gotta lean a bike up on that." Bride the bike guy said, don't forget those brown signs, man. Go find some of those historical markers and post some of those. And I've taken some photos of them, but dude, every brown sign that I've caught so far, it was 2.3 miles that way. It was a mile and a half that way. I'm like, no, special ed. Uh-oh, here we go. Mosquitoes, it's Louisiana state bird. That's cute. That's good. That's good because they're big here. And little bastards are sucking my ears dry. I wonder if I put on earplugs if it would make them stop. Probably not. Highly unlikely. So what else was there? Oh, we have a StreamYard. We could put a link up. Maybe we'll hear in a little while, but man, I don't know. I wanted to just give it a try and show that I had purchased it, whatever, to see if it worked or not. I was really curious. I still have I got to get a hotel room on Tuesday night. Although Chris is like, Jared, why don't you just go get a hotel room tonight? I'm like, I don't know. It's supposed to really storm tomorrow. So tonight, I think I'm going to suffer through tonight and, I'll find out how hard it's going to be tomorrow. But I sure want to get out of the great state of Louisiana tomorrow. So bad. I mean, I so bad I want to get out of here. I sure thought I was going to make it to Texarkana today. But it was not to be. It was in range. I was in range. I think it was going to be like 180 or 160 miles. Safety meeting. Thank you. Oh, what's up, Invent One. Motorized bike. Oh, damn, this StreamYard would let me play that tune. I'm gonna have to figure out how to get that in the background now. Oh, Invent. Oh, this is going to be cool. This is going to be cool. Definitely by Tuesday, maybe for tomorrow night. I just didn't have a chance to sit down and tickle it. I at least got the America the Ride-Along thing going on down there, I think. Yeah, that's what it says. Yeah, I'm looking over that street light over there. That thing's so much nicer and brighter, and I probably should just go walk over there and set up underneath that son of a bitch. But it's pretty good light. But it's got me blinded where I can't fucking see the words so easy. Usually when I'm doing StreamYard, I have that little thingy there. Let's just try something while we're just sitting here for a second. I wanted to try this right here. It says that I can add a video. Let's see if that actually works or anything. Oops. The file and the bits too large. Size limit of the video clip is 200 megabytes. To share longer video files, enter the studio on a computer. Ah, it said it shot me down. Kind of shot a little ride one, so I was hoping that we could show one, but I guess not. Yeah. Well, damn you guys. I am so sorry about that. I wasn't ready. Can we at least put a photo up or something? Can we put anything up? Let's see what happens when I do that. Add one. It's just a tiny little video. Now let's get back to the comments here. Let's see what happens. Oh, Kevin Shop is in here, guys, with a fucking banger. Quit it, Kevin. I'm going live every night of this thing, except for that one night with my mom's. Over my little brother's when I get there, we going live there with him. I'm going to drag that little son of a bitch in. He's at least going to sit across from me. I haven't seen that son of a bitch in, I don't know, 20 years. It's been 20. I bet it's been 20 years since I seen my little brother. He lives in fucking Wyoming and California and other long distance places that I have never... I never went to see him in. Everybody has seemed like they were doing pretty good so far, Kevin. I got good response from the folks who are here. And the fact that you're here, I'm so touched. David Westwood, damn, he made it. Thank you. I was rooting for you. So I did make up some stuff for everybody who would donate. Leonard Arola made it in the house. We're going to have to stay live for a little bit longer. Anyways, just so that way everybody can come in and check it out. I will rehash everything I'd said earlier at least a couple times. Let's see what happened with the video thing. Oh, it told me my other video was too big too. Well, everything I tried. Can't win them all. But I don't even know how many 200 megabytes is. Is that like 1 second or is that just a picture? I don't know. It said to add anything larger than that, I'd have to add a let's try this button right here. I would at least want the damn Bonnie and Clyde, which is oh, albums. Camera. Oh, it only shows videos. Oh, couldn't put a photo there, huh? That's crazy. All right, well, I'll have worked on something like that at a later date. Totally a waste of time. Yes, David Westwood, guys. A hell of a guy. Hell of a guy. You'd want to know him. If you knew him, you'd want to know him. He went into it from your friends. And Leonard Arola, same thing. I'm so glad to see you guys. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, what do we have? Eric Tennant with 1280x720. 1280x720. Is that what 200 megabytes is? I guess. Drone days. Camping with Jared. Yes, we are camping, guys. We're in the woods. Let's see in town. We got some woods behind us, but you go the other way. Can't see shit. I got a tree as my backstop. I thought it would help. It certainly helps me because I can lean back. It helps me a lot. Okay, so we got a max thumbnail size for YouTube. Gotcha. I get it. Yeah, it wouldn't. It said a video, though. It said, and when I tried the images just then, it would not let me go to images. But maybe it's because I'm fucking dicking around and didn't really look close enough. Here's something, Eric Tennant, I found out earlier. Just for your own information, this freaking Samsung phone has incredibly stable mode. Ah, what? Dude, it has an incredible stable mode. You click on this little running picture on there, and that camera looks like a freaking GoPro. I just found it fucking 30 minutes ago. Fucking awesome. Had no fucking idea I had that. You could wave your hand around, and it just shows what was right there. And I was like, oh my god damn. And it didn't move at all. It just stayed still even if you shake it. So that's on the Samsung S23 or something like that. I think it's what it is. So I don't know if everybody's got that, but I wouldn't be surprised if more phones have that than we think. OP1zilla is in the house. Check it out. Kevin Schaff is in here. OP, he's here. He made it in. Did y'all, okay, guys, so let's talk about Kevin for a minute. Did y'all see his running on the engine stand video? His short that he posted? That man is, guys, he is like the next level of every one of us. I swear. Older, wiser, smarter, better. Just fucking better. Saddle Tramp's in here. So happy to see you having such a good time. I think I have a pedal 50C old school build moped on the hook negotiating freight charges with Chinese company. That's cute. One of the guys up at the store that I work at in at home, he went and got a little Thomas. I think it was a Thomas. Is what he ended up getting, a little Thomas moped. He was riding that. I hate to say it, Eric, but he was riding that electric three-wheel, and he just wanted something with better range and better speed. And I'm like, he probably could have got better speed, but he felt, I don't know, he wanted something gas underneath him. And which I thought was cute. I couldn't believe he'd. Oh, I'm touching him. Sorry, guys. I get what's going on. David Dog. I spend 10% of what I make off YouTube. I spend 10 times of what I make on YouTube. I know. I've seen it. I have seen it. I've saved most of everything, waiting for the bigger purchases and when I soon can afford it. But I'm going to be on this thing, guys, for years and years and years to come. People will pass away in our community, and I will still be here. I'm not leaving. I'm fully addicted to doing this now. Jared gets a habit, and he doesn't quit. He refuses to quit. I don't start something that I wouldn't keep doing. Although I don't fish with a hook anymore. I guess there's some things, you know. I fish with a spear. I love spear fishing. I stopped fishing with a hook because I hate fucking catching shit I don't want to eat. With the spear, I eat everything I catch. And you can leave in one. Oh, what do we got? Mr. Lynn, OP, Dog, David, YouTube, Junior, we both may have a bit of OCD. We call Ollie live and... Damn it. Sorry, OP1. I can't read some letters that are on here. Dude, I'm struggling to read it. Goddamn fucking lights right in my fucking face. And it's got my pupils dilated. And fucking screen's white and the letters are black. And Saddle Trap comes in here with the... You know what I'm going to do? I'm not going to read them. I'm just going to post them there. It seems to be that's a far superior thing to do at this moment. Normally, I love reading freaking comments. Some kind of bike. I don't give a Fat Moto just got my inner energy up. I will have something better. Well, Saddle Jeff, you've already got quite a bit of stuff. And you said in the last one that you had been working on your 79cc. Now, I was curious what that project was going on. So I'm just taking it. It was a sitter mount, and we were still slowly putting together the parts and pieces for it. That engine plate, making it yourself is a tough one. Those ordering ones, they can be tricky on most frames. Raul and somebody else was telling me that. I think it was Raul mostly said that those. No, it was Motorized Andrew was saying that those cast iron block plates that are underneath it. If you're tightened down just a little too much, the thing will snap clean in half. He said they also, I think it was Raul who told me that if you keep using it, though, it will eventually just snap. So there's ways to replace some of those parts with steel instead of cast iron. Okay, we got Kevin with, I love the logo posted on the bottom of the video under. Yeah. Well, your name's going to be down there next time. I was supposed to be y'all's, everybody's name down there. It said I was allowed 1,000. That's before I was a paying customer. At least it said I was allowed 1,000 characters, which that's a lot of damn names. I could get a lot of information in down there if you used it that way. I don't know if there's music going on right now. There's supposed to be some sort of background track running, but I might not have got that up and running yet. I don't know. America Ride Along, more miles for miles. Yeah, I know, Kevin. Thank you, man. Thank you. I thought it was a good title. Chris, I was bouncing 100 titles off of Christy but give me some sort of title, you know? YouTube wants a title. They want a title, goddammit. They're like, title this shit, dude. So that was the best I could. So I've been coming live or shooting all my videos with the Welcome to America the Ride Along. I don't know. I was looking for something. I think people got by, or at least I did. I don't know, the Jared's bike check thing, and I'm like, no, Jared, you're gonna make all these new shorts. It needs to be exciting for them in that new way. And so I was like, whatever, fucking crazy stuff, crazy YouTube talk. I'm sorry. What about Kevin Schaap starting his engine on an engine stand, revving it, tickling on it, and then our little video ends? Oh, I am so curious to see his full video of this coming up. Or I hope I didn't already miss the full video and I got to go back and watch it tonight. But after the live, I at least get to sit around and watch videos, because it's, you know, we've got service and all here. How many bars have I got? I got two bars. I mean, that's as good as it gets, I guess, sometimes. Oh, that guy was biting right through my leg, pants and all. Son of a bitch, how long a proboscis has he got? Thing felt like a hypodermic needle. It did. He got me in the cab. How do you charge your stuff on the road? So I brought 45,000 milliamps with me. That's what it is, Kevin. I brought 45,000 milliamps with me. And, I probably got 10 charges on me. Maybe it isn't that many charges, but it's enough to get. So far, it held me for 3 days to get to my mom's. So I'm taking, I got at least, well, that was only the 20,000. The 20,000 kept me going for 3 days. And I still had the whole other big giant anchor, brand new 20,000. So it's always going to go a little further that first run and take a little longer that first time to charge. And then I'm hoping to stop at every, I stop at Dollar General's and stuff and that Walmart and just throw a battery on and just charge on it. Not charging the phone, charge the phone with the battery. But yeah, always trying to get a battery plugged in somewhere. One of the reasons I wanted to try, quit it, David Weston, dude, you've already earned my honor and respect, dude. 110%, dude. 110%. I mean, everything. We're going to keep doing this, though. If you'd like to come up and hang out with me on the StreamYard, I would be more than willing to hang out with anyone. I got like 6 to show for my trip tomorrow. I know, Eric. You got me so freaking jonesing to go, dude. I think you posted 3 trip videos. Yeah, it might have been 4 trip videos. I subscribe to Eric Tennis channel and I'm a member of it. And he shows me videos before he opens them out. And I'm not sure. I watched the short and then the long and then the short and then the long. No, the long and then the short, the long and then the short and then the long and the short. So I've seen all of them a couple of times. Tanboy Industries. Good evening, sir. Good evening. Let me, he's with us tonight. I'm glad. I knew it was going to take some people some time to come in. I should have put some sort of community post up just before I went or the notification thing that Kevin Schaap had been using. I still didn't exactly figure it out. I thought I did, but I didn't obviously get it correct this time. We have Jason Burke with, I made a live. You made the live? Or you made it to the live? Let me see that comment. I made a live. Dude, well, we're going over there. We're going to check it out, man. I want to see it. And if you made it to my live, welcome, brother. We're live from the bush. From the bush. Can't see any bushes? Nope. No. God damn, it's dark back there. I mean, goddamn. Fucking dark. You can't see shit back there. But luckily enough, that light's dying down some. That's what it seems like. Oops. No, it's not dying now. Never mind. Still crazy, blinding bright. So yes, I brought 40,000 milliamps, Kevin, and I shouldn't have any problems. If I end up feeling like I'm gonna buy another battery. I don't know, whatever, I'll go to Walmart or somebody and I will purchase another bigger battery again. Smoking Kush out in the bush. Yes. I seen Kush in the bush posted a safety meeting video. I think it was earlier. I think there are always lives from him too when he does those. Smoking pot in the woods down at the fort. Was he at I think he was at the fort. I didn't get to watch it. I just seen the thumbnail. Dave and his thumbnails. He's probably out smoking pot right now. Probably out front smoking pot. Mudding on the mini bike sucked. Mudding on the mini bike sucked. What size tire you got? What size tire? That's all we use the mini bikes for. We were, those are our little mud kings. That the Doodlebug was terrible at it, but that Warrior, he was pretty good at mudding. Sometimes it would shoot so much water up into the freaking the cowling or whatever, and it'd fucking die. The damn freaking thing would die right in the middle of the freaking puddle. So we found that to be a problem. Didn't really come up with a cure for that. My friend bought his motorized bike. Cool. Very cool. Very cool. Yeah. I even had the mud mower. I built the mud mower. We were fucking, but mostly what we did with it was pull a trailer with a couple of benches on it through the woods like a freaking haunted hayride. One of those. Dude, we every night. We did it for a long time, dude. I was hooked on it. Jump on the tractor, ride the trailer down to the river. People hanging out in the back with spotlights, looking around the woods. It was fun as shit. It was fun. And mostly it was because my big dog buddy. He couldn't go down the river no more, dude. Without a ride, man, he wasn't going. So we'd throw him up on the trailer. And it was so low to the ground, he'd jump off of while it was still going. And then he'd be all trying to catch up to it. We'd have to stop the damn tractor, let the dog catch up and get back on. Oh, Tony was, his little dog Shaggy was hanging out with us, and he'd go running crazy. Uh-oh, who is that? What did I just miss? I don't know. Grendel's Garage. Be safe, all. Thank you, Grendel's Garage. We really appreciate you coming and hanging out with us for a little while. I mention you all the time. I ain't gonna lie. I mention Grendel's Garage probably more than I watch it even, but I like that guy. Great video, great character, all that stuff. You and Doc Holliday, I thought were, you know, whatever. Seemed like y'all brought a lot of education to the game to start with. Eric Tennant, that same kind of way, you know. Was already ahead of a curve before we all got there. Even though, you know, but I'm sure you've watched our community videos and you're like, yeah, those guys suck, man. They can't even hold a damn camera still. So I do understand, you know. But it turns out clear footage is just harder to shoot than you think. Yes. That's a cute one. I did that one camping trip I posted, and I had snakes all around me down by in the bay there on a swamp, and I couldn't get a snake in the camera, dude. I shot him like 9-10 times. I had the camera all up on him, and you could never see a snake. One little video for about just a split second, and I slowed it down, way slowed down, and you can just see a blurry snake shape. And you're like, well, Jared, I don't know. Sometimes this is harder than you think, so I'm saying. The camera can't see what my eye sees. I seen it just fine. The camera, it didn't see it. Didn't see it at all. One of the reasons that I had just mentioned out loud, because of our community, that guys, there's a running picture on your camera. If you have a newer phone anyway, Samsung, I don't know from when up, you know, but I bet it's... But for most of the Androids, there's a little running looking guy on there. Push on that thing, and all of a sudden, it looks like we all got GoPros. I was stunned by that. I had no idea I even had that power. I even have a power where I can hit another button, and it goes full widescreen. And I'm like, get out of here. So, it should improve something. I don't know if y'all noticed that some of my shorts had that widescreen, even though that it was like this, but you could still see out like that. Yeah. StreamYard, if I flipped it around to the other side of the camera, that it is a very wide angle shot for StreamYard. Very wide angle. Like if you have it in your shop, and that's for something with Kevin's shop, if you're watching, this StreamYard, dude, on its on the backside camera, that when it's facing in, dude, it uses an incredibly wide shot. I mean, a really wide shot. It would cover your whole shop in a single image, or you know, from a single point, and the whole thing though, you know, 100 and something degrees. Phones are good at DVR as well. Phones are good at DVR. Digital voice recorder. I don't know. It's good. Video record? Digital video recorder? I don't know. DVR. Chrissy uses a DVR to record her fucking shows, right? So you mean screen recording? I guess that's maybe what you're saying, screen recording? I don't know. I don't know. I'm curious, though. Oh, shit. I never invited a guest. But because I'm stuck in the woods here, and it's still raining in these trees, guys. And just because it stopped raining out there, which it was, because I went and walked it, trying to find somewhere else. So I'm curious if the freaking guests and all the work still and all that. Oh, guys, I cannot pin my own message, though. That's the problem. I'll never be able to pin that. I don't have a second device to pin the fucking comment from my own channel. That's cute. Is there anything I can do to it? Nope. Well, if anybody does want, it's all right. It'll be on there. Maybe you could go back in there. Okay, a digital video recorder records video in local storage devices, most commonly a hard drive. Okay, thank you, sir. I'm more savvy now. My little brother's supposed to be savvy, but he didn't show us anything. I'm going out to see his ass, so maybe he'll refresh me on a few things. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe he'll be watching it. My brother Stacy's supposed to be in here, and Tony, but like I said, Christy's not in here yet either. And so I've noticed that not everybody's getting their notification things or whatever. Christy said, I don't get any notification. I just been checking randomly to see if you fucking went live. I think Dave told me that the other day too. He's like, dude, no, I'm just fucking checking randomly. About here and then about here. And if you are, if you ain't, you ain't. What else was there? Did I meet anybody today? I have, I talked to someone, surely. Yeah, I talked to the guy at the museum, the guy behind the counter. I'll do that. Oh, there she is. That guy behind the counter at the Ambush Museum. Ambush Museum. I mean, come on now. Dude, he had all his paraphernalia, pictures of all the people that the famous people that had come through that little place to see his shop, his little museum, and he had Kevin Costner and Swamp People, or had been in there just recently, and a whole litany of different stars and stuff who'd come by to see it all gunshot up, and I'm like, dude, y'all at least got a bar in there, you know, a bar. He's like, no, we don't have any BAs in there. Are you? He said he had a Thompson. And I'm like, it ain't worth it. I've seen too many. I've never actually got to see a BAR up close. I want to see the fucking BAR. I know we don't never talk, but I did. I just wanted to, you know. It's one of those fascination things just from the whole Bonnie and Clyde story, you know. Was Trump in there? I don't think Trump would come through old Gibson. Drone days. For the win. Do you have Kendricks? Oh, do you have Kendricks in your family? Well, I don't think so. Nope. Desermo? Although they could have married in, they marry people all the time, you know, and divorce and breed and stuff. I don't know what they're up to. I'm trying to catch up with as many as I can before, you know, maybe one of them passes or something. But mostly they had to forget why they hated me from a long time ago, apparently. And then once they forgot, a little, you know, like, yeah, I'd see you. Yeah. It'd be cool if you come on up. I don't know. They never invited me before. They didn't invite me either. I told them I was head. Nobody invited me. I said, I'm coming. Be expecting me type of thing, huh? Fuck it, you ain't gonna fucking invite me. I'm heading, man. Good weed. Thank God for good weed, guys. Man, it makes a trip so much better. Yes, you remind me of the half brother with that last name. Oh, could be. Could be. I tell you what, with my last name, if you have it, you're related. It's a fact. I have the big book of Desermo. I shit you not. I guess I ordered or Christy ordered it a long time ago, one of those little mail order things, you know, long before the internet. And they would send you this book with your family tree breakdown. Was it real? Is it just from the census board? Who knows? But there's a good fucking 2,000 names in it there. And you can go and listen. You know, there I am. Hot damn. There's my brothers. And there's my dad. And there's his dad. So, I mean, I don't know. That Adesimo won the Kentucky Derby about 6-8 years ago, I remember. And turns out that guy was absolutely related. Distant relation, but he still had our name. Won the fucking Kentucky Derby. So Adesimo has done something. Good weed makes everything better. My buddy Colby, I can thank my buddy Colby for making sure I had some of that damn pot he'd had in a while for me. And I appreciate that. Uh-oh, Kim Scrambler. Good evening, sir. Good evening. Mr. Taking Time. Okay, Stacy says it was 20 fucking years ago. It was 20 years ago, dude? Oh, been a while. Like I said, it's been a lot of it. It's been a while. You want to try your hand out on the old stream yard, Stacy? You can jump on. I don't know why I keep putting my hand up like there's going to be a breeze. There is no fucking breeze. Y'all see it? I am a little sweaty in that way. I mean, it's fucking hot in the woods. This is southern. This is very south feeling in that way of, oh, yeah. Even deep in the tree. Yeah, dude, it's got a mugginess in there. Dude, it must be 86 degrees. Because it felt cooler out on that goddamn road over there when I was out there before. You know, and now it's a, maybe I'm just getting excited. I'm jacked up. Feel on the spot type of thing. Hello, you guys. Good evening, Kim. Yes, I put it up. I did put the link up, but you got to go back there. You have to go back. Just scroll back just a little ways. Boom. And there it is. I'll put it up again, though, just because. Oh. Uh-huh. Yeah, because as y'all's chat goes up, I don't think you can go that far back in time, can you? Oh, leaving a comment on this thing is fucking tough as shit. God damn it. They are just draining me tonight, guys. I cannot believe how much blood they have already found from me. And I got sleeves on and everything, you know. I'm pretty bug-proof. They are finding any naked spots they can catch. 38 here. Drone day is 38. That's terrible. That's terrible. But I did check the phone before I went live there. It was 82. But I would imagine it's going to stay that way. And finally, when cold air shows up, that'll be what blows the you can scroll back on your phone. Oh, you can. Okay, so you can't scroll back on it. I didn't know if you could scroll back or not. I can only scroll back a little ways on the StreamYard right now. Yeah, a chunk, but you know, but all the way back to the beginning. Well, I can get back to the beginning on it. But oh, yeah, I thought you could on YouTube though. But it might also just be because I'm on a damn cell phone and it seems to be all kind of weird special rules for the damn cell phone. Yeah. Thought I heard thunder again. I'm like, oh, no, come on now. No, there's no more thunder. Yeah, so here's the other thing. The wind hasn't blown since the fucking rain came. That rain was just straight down. And these trees are just still, they're still raining. There has not been a breeze big enough to fucking, you know, shake the trees. And as far as it, I can tell, you know, it's just raining all around. I have y'all underneath the umbrella. I got the phone and everything set up off the front of the bike under the umbrella, and I'm sitting out here in the old, like a savage in the elements. 78 in Houston. Yep, thanks, Saddle Tramp. Yeah, some sort of big skeptical force. Skip's in here. Should be getting more clear. Yeah, no, my mom watched your video, sir. And Christy watched it. Dude, they were so impressed with you. They were, I ain't gonna lie, dude. She was so, man, you fucking knocked my mom's socks off, dude. She was fucking floored. I ain't gonna lie. Windy as shit, overcast tomorrow. Windy as shit, overcast tomorrow. So the wind will come in and it should bring cold air with it, but it'll blow stormy stuff away. And cold is definitely dry. That was one of the things I didn't really get to laminate with Christy on was, you know, a lot of the cold, vroom, 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 what's up, enthusiasts? There's some advantages to cold. Maybe not snowing, but cold and clear is dry and beautiful and it can be tolerated. It just takes a couple layers and then you're good. DNS, two-stroke, motorized bicycles. What the hell? I don't get any notifications on you going live. I was just saying that. That's why I can't just leave in an hour. Fuck that. I'm going to stay for another, you know, half hour, hour more or whatever. Guys, we're live. We'll hang out for a while. I'm fucking good. There's a nice piece of woods right here behind that shopping center. I can be as loud as I like. Oh, I should have taken a... for the live, I should have used that photo as a screenshot type of thing. I didn't... This doesn't have a thumbnail, does it? No, it just went up as a picture or something. That's right. Yeah, whatever. I didn't get a... Did not get the... whatever. I didn't understand how to do it. I didn't know what I was doing. I can only go back and do it afterwards. I know how to add it. Tomorrow, tornado watch for... Whoa. Tornado watch for the... And an eclipse. That's right. So, Skeptical Forest, apparently I did not make it to a far enough north destination to get a total solar eclipse where I'm at, apparently. That's what I was told by my phone. And, but yeah, that I would be overcast gray all the way up to New York, I believe is what they said. So the only people who are going to get a good viewing of it was the very high northeast would have a great viewing of the solar eclipse, and the rest of the country ain't going to be nothing but gray. So in time, probably not. What do we have that's further north? You'll be close. New York here. Trone Days is in New York. Okay, so you're probably going to catch it then, aren't you? Well, I hope you don't turn into a goddamn zombie like The Day After. Remember that movie, The Day After? there was an eclipse, and then there was a meteor, and then everything, you know, everybody left was zombies. La, 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 la. You'll still see something. I know, that's what I figured. I feel like I catch something. But you're no way in the path. Yeah, Erica, if you could, yeah, you're a little too far west in that way. It'll still be a partial, though. Although, to you, it'll probably look like the sun's still shining. Although, if you had your loom meter out there, look, it plummeted. I still have a lumen meter. I had to know. And then when you take it outside, you're like, oh my God, it just breaks a goddamn dial. You're like, and instantly, dude, just boom. And you're like, holy shit. Oh, yeah, it's bright out here, dude. And you take it in the grow room and you're like, looking for it, trying to raise it. And you got to jam right up against the light. And you're like, Okay, that's sufficient, man. It's putting out enough. No. In the shade, dude. You cover it up and that thing will hammer over it. Sun is king of grow lights. It is. That's why I'm talking about it. It's just so amazing that it's putting out so much fucking juice, dude. I mean, that's a lot. Especially if you played around in a grow room trying to make your own light. You're like, realize, holy moly, there's a lot of light outside. I can't even come close. I'm not even ballparking it. It needs to be within 4 inches. Because it plummets fast as you get away from the source. You're like, oh my God. Yeah, 24 inches. That's it. That's maximum distance. My brother Stacy would know a thing or two about this. Oh, I got me a ride in today. It was a nice just to be, yeah, here we go, able to open it up again. I missed it. Got zip tie on the road. I did see you posted one. Like I said, I could watch a bunch of videos after this tonight. Catch you up on a bunch of stuff. Makes me want to build a smart grow house. Smart grow house. I think they call that a greenhouse. It's just glass. You know, they just use glass. It does fine. But you know what they do in those? They use supplemental lighting with the grow lights. And oh my God. They're like, yeah, no, dude, these plants never miss a beat. They get bigger. Which is a thing. You know, there's a lot of commercial uses for that. Supplementing the light in a damn greenhouse. And yeah. Oh, we got Jason Burke with solar panels to grow weed. Smart greenhouse next. Wait, smart greenhouse year. Yeah, I'm going to be on the road, Eric, for 420. That's going to happen while I'm on the trip this time. I've never been on the trip when the 420 came around. And I think I'll be in Colorado. That's what I'm hoping for. Now that I know that, you know, that would be something like, you know, to look towards 420. Yeah, I mean, I might be out of Colorado by then, but I'll be in some marijuana state for sure. Got 30,000 kilowatts solar on the roof. 30,000 kilowatts, baby. How far is that from a gigawatt? I mean, gigawatt. A gigawatt. What is it? 80 million gigawatts? 1.7 gigawatts? Get the old flux core capacitor fired up. Single use stuff, though. You know, you've zapped it. It's only good one. Got some weed called Candyland. I like that. That's a good name for one. Woke up one night and my wife was shining. Oh, whoa. Was shining a grow light on my Mr. Happy. what do we got? Fluorescent shop lines. Alter spectrum bulbs, let them grow light to the bulbs. Yeah, I know the system. I know exactly that system, the T5 lighting. T5 fluorescent lighting. Or at least that's what it was when I was back playing with it. I've got cookie crumble. I thought you said you had some European weed, dude. Tell me what that European one was. You said that you had ordered seeds for some Euro. Smells sweet. I can't remember. I couldn't remember the damn name for that Euro one. Three sets of 6 bulbs suspended from ropes on ceiling made a nice setup. Yes. Yep. Yeah, I was running, I don't know, 3,000. I was running 2,000 sodiums and 1,000 halide. So a lot. It was a lot. It was bright. I didn't fuck around those 600, dude. You know, 600. Oh, it did. 1,000. Now 1,000 is just better. It's just fucking about bigger and better. I tried the 600. 1,000 is bigger and better. Uh, So Mike Miller that hangs out with us here, that's my only electrician, and that I know is how to rig and wire grow lights. The only thing I took the time to learn that shit, dude, wasn't nobody was going to teach me. Oh, to upload a video, I have you on my TV, can text back, but can hear you all. What? Jerry, trying to upload a video, I have you on my TV, don't text back, but can hear you all. Huh. I wonder. Sounds cool. BRB. BRB. I don't know what the hell. Just scored a 100-watt LED for $50. New LVS adjustable and puts out a lot of good light. That's cool. Yeah, Eric Tennant, David Weston, he's been doing some repairs. He did some replaced some diodes on one bulb, and maybe I can't remember what he said, the controller or something, the power controller, I don't remember. But just for the video, he just did the diode. So got both lights up and running again. And you're like, yeah. And but I never got to use any of those. I ain't gonna lie. I didn't make it to them. I never made it to them. They were too immature when I was messing around with it. Now they're probably not as they're probably effective now. Although I see that they are casting the same spectrum, but you said 100 watts, and I'm like, 100 watts. There's probably even a higher efficiency rating for per watt lumen received per watt from an LED as well. So I don't know. More I don't know. Tried hydro a bunch of times. You know what? I couldn't learn water. Nah, man, there's a lot to know about water. Saltwater fucking fish tank, saltwater swimming pool, fucking... Yeah. Left it alone. Just left it. Miracle-Gro. That's what I would recommend. Miracle-Gro. Just use it. Hydro my world. Oh yeah, no, I did it, but it was too much of a burden. It was a labor. It was, whatever. And I was trying to recycle. Oh, the recycling was just so hard to do. Deep water culture for flood or feel. Yes, that's what I was doing. But run to waste. Just run to waste. But what did I find more than anything was, just make sure there's air in it. But if you keep adding air to the solution, you are adding heat. You can't stop it. So then you need a water chiller. And then, you're going down that road. And now you need to know what the dissolved solids are. So you need the EC. It's just a fucking never-ending road. What you do is take some Miracle-Gro, you pour it on it. Whatever runs out goes into a tray. That's what I did. Runs into a tray. It soaks it back up by wick. And I did. A totally fucking lazy way. And she still didn't want to deal with it. Okay, so you know that what they are. So apparently there is a higher efficiency rating. 1 to 6. pH 58. 5.8. Yeah, man, you got to run with the pH. Oh, shit. Who knew? Then fucking rock wool. God damn stuff. No, I fucked around for some years, guys. I ain't gonna lie. It was stupid. We don't grow our own tomatoes. And that's what we ended up equating it to, We ain't growing our own salad. We ended up. Well, maybe that's a breeze blowing out the trees, or maybe it's raining again. We're going to find out. Wear gloves with rock wool. Yes. Wear gloves with rock wool. Now, as a professional drywall and metal framer, Rockwool was part of the job, especially out on those military installations, dude. They want that Rockwool packed around every piece of iron and steel and as much as you can possibly get on it. Yeah, there's a breeze. Oh, you bastards. Get it done. Well, there, the breeze finally blew through it and made it rain. I knew it was gonna happen. Yeah, so we were growing our own for quite a long time. And then we gave up. Well, I guess I wasn't gonna go to work and do it. I'm like, Christy, you take care of this stuff. You're here. And fuck that. We're buying it. That's true. That's God's honest truth. That's where it ended. Come on, quit it. Bastard. I'll put some more weed in here. Now that we're talking about it. Okay, so let's talk more about we got fucking sitting around talking smoke. I can't even believe that. Although apparently a better part of the portion of the crowd is definitely into smoking. So I mean, it's one of the things I'm into. There's a few drinkers I'm sure out there. I don't know. I like that too. I've never knocked nobody for doing nothing. Although some people do stuff and hurt other people, I'm against that. That's all I'm gonna do. Well, no, I'm against that. But otherwise, no, you know, I'm not. I don't think very many of us do drink. I don't know. You would think old Raul would be a drinker. He ain't no drinker. He smoked a few times with us on here, but he always take a puff or two and put it away. He's like, I'm trying to hang out with y'all live, man. I ain't got time to get all stoned. I don't even remember what the hell I'm doing. Bunch of potheads. That's what I'm trying to say, man. This was a bunch of fucking potheads. That's right. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, so I don't mind. I don't mind. It's always been my best crowd, my most friends. And yeah, I've always enjoyed them. And they're friendly. Never. Yeah. I gotta lift my pipe. Be back. He took the time to type it. I'm sitting here kind of oblivious, I can't deny. But I forget that there's a damn street light behind this. But this fucking light's in my face, so I can't. It's absolute black in front of me. And for y'all, it's absolutely black behind me. Which is fucking hilarious in that way that neither one of us can see jack shit except for the camera. Come on now. That was terrible. Went right through my hat and all. Through them big droplets. Little mini hurricane just in there, whatever. Although Skip said, watch out for tornadoes on his early comments. And I'm like, oh no. Was that Raul? Uh-oh. Here we go. Got some mic talk. Jared, my nieces wants my Super Phantom Menace 85 motor. I let her ride it today. My old lady asked me if your niece was still around or not. Raul, I put up a link, Raul, if you go back in the chat and there's a link. I have no way to pin it tonight, so I've left it up twice now, but. Yeah, I'll throw it up one more time just so I can hang out with my fucking partner, Raul. We are here. Once again, I'm doing it wrong. Invite a guest. Copy and paste. Fling up a chat. Yes. So we're live from the bush again, Raul. We're still out on the road. Other people might have showed up here. So we've covered 118 miles today. We made it to Well, if you have to, you have to. If you don't, that's all right. Go. I don't mind. We got a we made it to. Somebody have to go to the beginning of this, dude, and tell me what the hell I was in. I posted it on both of those videos. Oh, Minden. I think it was Minden, Louisiana. I think I might be wrong. Minden. I think it was Minden. And we stopped because of a broken derailleur, a cable, broken derailleur cable. And the hanger was floppy, the derailleur hanger. And then... Or with motor, dude. Uh-oh. What do we got? Raul, California Motorbikes was V3 cylinder exhaust only. A few. Where the motor, dude? Prayer country. It's prayer country. Oh, guys, I seen the biggest. I swear to you, I seen the biggest cross you have ever seen. It's over there by OP Onezilla. Do you know the cross I'm talking about, dude? This thing was like, I think my mom said it's 250 feet tall. Guys, it was a colossus. It was the arms out on it. I don't know, 100 feet long. It was so stupendous. And then the picture I have it, you can see all the work vehicles underneath it. Are these big? They're little bitty vehicles. I was a Sasquatch out there. You do see one. Well, get over here, dude. I got some lead now. You know Sasquatches is potheads, man. There's no way they could be running around sober all these years. They probably don't think of it getting high. You know, it's just natural. Whoa, I've seen people living under a trailer in Kennethville. Yeah, well, I've seen people living in tunnels in Tucson. And I'm serious, dude. Dug into this, the riverbank there, dude. They tunneled in. There was families in there. Guys, I am not fucking kidding. Eric Tennant has these tunnel situations going on around his city in Phoenix there. There are mole people out there. I heard New York has a problem with mole people as well. But I've seen it. It was real. It was real. And then I pull into Bly, California on my last trip. I'm shit fucking not, dude. I pull into fucking Bly, California, and there's a dude, there is a man crawling out of a fucking half sewage thing in a garage right there, dude. And he crawling, belly crawling his way out like the fucking Walking Dead. I shit you not, man. Drug himself out of there and got up. And this, he had this lurch to him. He had this lurch. and he lurched his way across the street, dude. It was the craziest shit I've ever seen. it's not the craziest. That was not the craziest. It was not. I was in Sanderson, Texas, waiting on a train. And there was a grown man out in the middle of Highway 90 trying to get truckers to pull over dressed in a big pink bunny suit. I seen him, dude. I was a little scared. That one scared me. I'm like, something about the bunny suit, man. That creeps me out. I'm like, yeah, no, dude, this guy is totally fucking lost his shit. I wish I had pictures of that. It matters. Oh, I can't read it because the goddamn light. Oh, but I can read it when it's highlighted like that. Shame of the bus stops have a hide where the advertisement is. smoking some devils these days. Dude, I don't know what that guy was smoking, man, but he was lurching, he was surging forward. And then So check it out. So directly across the street in Bly, there where I was at, was a there was a fucking pot store. I got made it to California. I'm going in the weed store. And there's no fucking way I'd leave my bike up. There's no fucking way. Dude, there was 20, 30 people. Remember when I used to look out in front of them old in the 70s and 80s, 90s, maybe a little bit, and out in front of the liquor store, there'd be all these fucking people lingering and shit. Dude, it was just like that. And I mean some of the sketchiest fucking dregs of society you'd ever see. And you're like, yeah, Jared, you can't leave your bike up right there. No, I can't walk in. I can't walk in right there. I can't go in. You can't just leave this up and walk inside. You just have to know when you can and when you can't. And that's definitely when you can. Small thing. Small thing. I liked the DeBoer guy at the end of Swamp Thing. I always thought that was a, good team up, matchup. Swamp Thing versus that big fucking boar, Russian boar looking tusk. When did I see Swamp Thing last? So, it's been 20, 30 years though. So I remember, some movies, dude, I don't rewatch. Dude, I have a fondness for some of these movies, and I am not fucking rewatching them and absolutely ruin them. Dude, I remembered that movie as it was so good, and now I'm rewatching it. Dude, that thing was B. That was B at best. Did I laugh at this? Oh, yeah. Swamp Thing. I remember. But I think Tony sold me some Swamp Thing one time, though. So I'm not sure. This might be a free weed. My friend one time, he said, hey, Jared, come here. Come check this out. I said, dude, I got chocolate weed. What? Yeah, man, I got some chocolate. Dude, you got to check this shit out. And I walked out to his truck and that shit was a fucking brown fucking Mexican brick weed. Yeah, man, it's chocolate. Oh, he got me, dude. He got me. Oh, I was kind of, on the way out there. No, that's not okay. Oh, Dano. You know, Dano just smoked. Dano's a drinker, like beer, like a little whiskey. No, you guys like this stuff. I know you guys like this stuff. You know what? Crazy thing. Oh, Dano from Arkansas, from Little Rock. I just thought of that, dude. Yeah, that's kind of the reason why I was wanting to go through, not to see it, but just to make mosey my way through Arkansas. Texarkana, I thought it was going to be far enough. Eduardo Espinoza. I can't get that. I wonder if I even say that when I do say it. I hope I didn't miss Raul popping up here and I missed it because I'm, fucking half fucking baked and staring around. I'll check it out this other time. There was this guy, his first move down to fucking, to Fort Walton Beach, Florida. And they, guys, I'm working out of a labor fighters. I'm still like 16 years old. My mom runs the place, so, I'm just getting tickets every day. I mean, every day I get a ton of tickets. And dude's like, hey, man, you want some spider bud? Of course I do. I'm like 16. Yeah, dude, I ain't got my own source of weed since I got here in any kind of way. Yeah, man, I'm going to get you some spider bud, man. And, okay, you come back by here around 6, it's our place. He would come back by. I'm going to be here. We were living in that shop. And, dude, it was some freaking Leafs and Tops. It was some Leafs and Tops, fucking some Leafs and Tops, man, in a fucking baggie. They were fucking just soaking wet. They weren't kind of dry or anything. Just some Leaf, man. The man sold me some Leaf. Ah, those were the days. I smoked that shit.
I didn't have nothing, man. I was out, out, out.
Had been out too for a good little few minutes. So, those are totally unbike related. But for me, they're trip related. Here, we're going to see if somebody can sign in live while I am on a fucking trip in the middle of a fucking bush at the stage. Hot damn, we got Rob on the fucking show. Live from the fucking bunker. Good evening, sir.
Anyway, like I said, my niece wants my Super Phantom motor. She said that it handles like an ATV quad.
That's good. That's good. That's really good.
If we trade motors, I want the version 2 Phantom so I can do the same mods that the other one has.
Oh, yeah. Well, very cool.
That thing's loud as hell. And we're both racing both bikes, and it turns out the Cabra piston rings is what fixes the original Phantom motor.
The copper? You said copper?
No, the Cabra piston rings, 1.5 millimeter.
Wait, it was thinner? Ultimately, they end up thinner pistons?
Thicker.
I mean, thicker rings? Thicker rings. Okay. Do they fit in the grooves?
No. The engine still runs.
No, do the rings fit in that groove that's cut for them? Yeah, it does.
They fit for a MS-460 piston.
Oh, yeah. Very cool.
The piston, yeah, but when I ordered the Menace 85 cylinder, Smollett hooks you up with the MS-460 piston, and he drilled his own reed valve holes for the piston. But the stock piston rings that it comes with, I didn't use. I ordered the Cabra piston rings and forced them on there.
Good. Good. I'm glad.
The motor's still holding up.
You've got a good 200 miles on it now, don't you? Yeah. Yeah. With a few test rides on with other people on it.
Yep. She took that's good. Test ride, and that damn thing took off.
Yeah.
Yep.
She wanted a piece of it now, huh?
Yeah. She's like, let's trade bikes. I said, no, I can hook yours up the same way. Pay for the chop top service.
The chop top.
Jason says their Cabra rings are made of better Italian metal, better made. Yep.
Call Gail. Good evening. He did make it eventually. Goodness gracious, I'm glad he made it. He's still gonna be here for a minute. Everybody's just doing up.
Hey, guess what? I found my glasses.
Yeah, you found them for the last one. And you said you had an extra pair of them just in case.
Yeah, I thought KGB took my glasses.
Got Putin over there looking under your damn shit, taking your stuff.
Hey, he was trying to steal some of your wrenches.
He took them in for questioning.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was looking for questioning.
So did you the four-stroke build you did? Did you attach a bicycle speedometer, or are you using one of those digital ones?
Use your Google Maps and you hit directions for it, and then you hit start, you get a speedometer.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I don't know if you knew that or not, but there's a speedometer on there, so you can how accurate. Google accurate, I guess. I mean, that seems to be pretty accurate. What have I been doing? I've been sticking to the 23s.
Does that annoying noise, voice come on and tell you in a couple miles turn right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. And I anywhere around over 15 though, she disappears. Ain't gonna lie. Like, after 15 miles an hour, yeah, you can't go more. Too much wind on your ears already now. She ain't loud enough.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Should have took a Bluetooth plug-in or something.
Yeah.
Like an earpiece or something.
I thought about it, but that's just too much chasing battery. I'm not gonna lie, I would have been keeping it charged too much. Because I'd want to listen to it constantly. I don't know. Popped in. All right. He's been hanging out with us recently.
Yep. Any juicy bugs? What?
Any juicy bugs?
I don't know. Bri the bike guy says any juicy bugs.
Oh, Bri the bike guy. He made it in. Dude, he's just getting here. Hot damn, I didn't know. I didn't see him earlier, at least. No, sir. Did you see that one? I did. I shot a short, dude. The motherfucker flew right in my fucking mouth while I was talking on the fucking camera. And he's like, you son of a bitch. I swallowed him, dude. He went straight to the back. He went right to the back. No, dude, he went down. There was no way but to go. I didn't even get a taste of him. He was lined perfect to just go... Right back there. Hit the back wall and I swallowed.
Yeah.
I know,
hopefully it wasn't a big. Hopefully it wasn't a big June bug.
It was some sort of little teeny, I don't know, flying thing. It could have been a dirt clod, though. You never know. I don't know what it was. I'm betting it was a bug. They've been, you can hear.
I said he almost laughed so hard that he almost puked.
I hear him going off my helmet. Tink. Tink. I had something big, dude, hit me right in the damn corner right here, the eyeglass and the head right there. Dunk. I'm glad I had eyes on. I don't know what it was, dude. It was a big bug though. It went thump.
Maybe he was trying to hitchhike.
Holy. I don't know if I killed him, but he was trying to take me out. I want to say it was a dragonfly. I don't know though. Man. I think he hit me head on, and it was gone a split second later. And I thought a wasp hit me right here the other day. Thunk, and I looked down, but I couldn't be sure. And then he was gone too.
Saddle Tramp says midnight bugs taste best.
What do we have from Eric here? David America was also. I can't fucking read it without highlighting it.
Something about lead based in paint or lead in paint.
Who's David America?
I don't know.
It sounds like
Would that be house paint with the lead base paint or the Chinese
paint? Yeah, I think that was house paint usually. I bet it was really good paint.
Mike Miller said it. Them cicadas will knock you off your bike.
Christy warned me about it. She said, at some point, Jared, there might be cicadas. And then we looked at it. It must be the summer or something, I think. And then it's later in the year before this cicadas start going to ride. But you know there's going to be a super... Dude, you're in it. Do you eat them? You better come up with a dish, dude. Yeah, they're good. There are going to be a lot of them in your house, dude. I mean, like 6 quintillion of the motherfuckers. You didn't know that? This is the year of cicada. There's like 3 major hatchings that's supposed to happen this year. Some 17-year ones and some 11-year ones all at once. And whatever. It's supposed to be a mega bloom. It's across the northeast right there. Down to the Great Lakes.
I heard that Op One Zilla is supposed to send me a camera mount.
Which camera?
I don't know. Hopefully it's a camera mount that screws in.
Uh-huh.
The camera I got needs one of those mounts so I can have the camera like this instead of going down like that. It's an old chest mount rig. He said he was going to send me.
Well, cool. That'd be very cool. That'd be very cool.
Right now, I need new clutch pads. Right now, I need new clutch pads for my Adventure 85. I burned them pads out, man.
You did not. You said that they were RDM pads.
Driving.
And how many pads you put on?
RDM pads. I'm
Kush in the like, bush. 16. God damn it. Kush, we are fucking live in the bush, sir. Stealth Camping fucking Alliance. Where's the goddamn tree at behind me? There. We're here, dude. We're
some extra stuff. What kind of...
It's so dark behind me. You can't...
Opwinzilla said he threw in some extra stuff for me. You better find that damn chest mount rig because I'm going to need it.
Crystal meth. What do we have? Just got here. Jared, where are you? How many miles? Okay, Kush in the bush, dude. I made it 118 miles today. I'm in... Dude, I already smoked all that fucking pot. Minden. I'm in Minden, Louisiana. I was on my way to Texarkana at about 118 miles. I had a small break in my rear derailleur and stopped at Walmart to repair the cable. Got out of the store, fixed the fucking cable, got into the fucking parking lot, leaving the fucking store. Woof, fucking the skies opened up on me. They dumped some serious shit. So I rolled across the street there where there was some big shopping center stuff there. And I went and waited underneath the awnings there and found an umbrella while I was there even. And then I went behind the shopping center. In that patch of woods behind the shopping center, I'm there in the bush. So,
you got a free umbrella.
I did pick. Y'all are underneath the umbrella right now. I am out here in the elements. So the rig got some protection. It is still raining in the fucking bush here. Every time there's an even micro wind, the whole goddamn thing starts to dump on me all over again. There hasn't been a big enough wind to blow all the fucking water out of the trees yet. That was a bit, did I cover everything? What else? Did anything else happen? And I went to the Bonnie and Clyde Ambush Museum.
Now, when you say the old crappy clutch pads, Opwinzilla, are they the pink ones? Or the red eraser ones?
You can make your own.
I know. But I need spares right now.
Get some bicycle tire. You cut some nuggets. And then you cut them down. And you put them in the little squares. And there you go. That's what came on our links. If you got... When you got your first kit from Pirate Cycles, inside there was goddamn pieces of tire. Little cut up pieces of tire, just like your fucking rag joint. It was literally the same fucking material. Cut into nuggets.
Yeah, and then they put like anti-scratch, what the hell is it, cloth material on top of that. And then they glue it all together.
No, it was just a little piece of tire. Just nuggets cut out with a stamp. And you just push them in. And shit, just trash.
So trash, I don't know. An old ass bicycle tire, nice.
Yeah, but I'm trying to. But it needs to have a little bit of thickness. You'll notice what the thickness needs to be. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, not a lot of it, but you know, it's got some thickness to it. Something with some tread still a little bit, you know. So it's got some height. Sidewall. So I think is what they were using, sidewalls off of car tires, you know, or something like that. It's what it looks like. Some sort of a.
Yeah, they took an old tire to make those two pieces of the rag joint. They took old two pieces of a car tire, cut the sidewalls out, and then
they use the sidewall material. Yeah, good material.
They used They used the drill and they drilled the 6 or 9 hole design in it. Yep, and then they give you those mounting brackets and shit, and then you clamp it to the spokes, and then you tighten it down.
It's a good use for a readily available material. They did have quite the design on the little China kit in that way. When you're looking at it from the little Chinese guy's perspective of, could he manage to keep this little thing running? Yeah, it's pretty close, man. Pretty close. You just get a couple of straight parts put in it here and there, and it should run. That thing should run.
Did you see my other set where I had the, what was the Generation 2 or Generation 3? They stepped up from away from the rag joint, and they made the metal CNC clutch plates. I got the silver one, and I got the red one.
Oh. Wow.
They just clamp onto the spokes. I bought the
entire disc with good pads for $11. Cool. But look at that. We're having a fucking live anyways. Probably like, let me get on here. Got some.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold on. You can use a lawnmower belt and cut them into clutch pads.
A what?
A lawnmower belt to make clutch pads.
Who threw us that one?
Jason.
Jason Burke?
Yeah. He says you can use a lawnmower belt and cut it into clutch
pads. That's a goddamn good one, dude. There's that thickness that we were talking about.
You would have to have a sharp pair of fucking, like almost like something as sharp as bolt cutters in order to make clutch pads.
Why?
So you can cut the lawnmower belt into little squares.
Your mom's got a pair of scissors in the kitchen beside the sink, dude, called kitchen shears. Yeah. Cut the hell out of it.
Sit there and cut them out.
Oh, the belt's already going to be almost the right size. You just got to cut it to length. That's what I think he was saying. What does he have?
Tractor Supply Kevlar with coaxial cable cutters. See, he knows everything. Shit.
Okay.
How much is that tool, the coaxial cable cutters? I might pick me up a pair.
Oh, you know what they are? They're those blades with that curve, you know, that U curve, and it's sharp like this. It looks like two hooks coming together. I'm just saying, I know exactly the one he's talking about in that way, that coming sharp from both sides to shear.
Just don't get your finger in there.
I would take fingers off easily. Look, it looks like you're supposed to take a finger off.
Yeah, don't be like Build Break Fix's neighbor sawing his hand off or his fingers.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay, I had well over 3K miles on the first. Give me that one. Watch it. Yeah, see, Brian the Bike, I had told us this last time on his first build. Right? On the
two-stroke or four-stroke kit?
Two-stroke kit. The first China Girls. He's been playing the game for a good while. And, he uses that thing, dude, like transport. Dude, he uses it as transportation all the time, full time, no car. I don't think he lost his car either. He got rid of his car.
Too expensive. Anyway, were you pissing with the carburetor and that half moon key or the, what the hell they call it? The C clip washer or whatever the hell it is that's supposed to hold the needle thing down? Did it go into the intake?
Yes, that's what he's talking about. He did say washer. So he must have meant the C-clip, circlip.
Let me guess. It got wedged with the C-clip up into the engine wall.
Oh, I bet it finished it off. I bet it ground out a nice gouge where it would fit, and then it fell inside. Right? If you got lucky, it tried to blow it out the exhaust.
Yeah.
Probably not, though. Nobody does. It already stopped running before that, I guarantee you. Those walls,
anyway, like I said,
a tiny scarring.
I tried to buy a bottom end, a YD-100 bottom end, not the old one, the newer ones, with the 12-millimeter wrist pin. Tried to get one for $89, and the dude tried to rip me off, keep the money, and not send me the bottom end.
Okay.
So I told him, you can keep the motor, give me the money back. Because I was interested in building my own Avenger motor for my MTB Green Mongoose bike.
All right. So you're still just retiring the bottom end again.
Yeah. I'm retiring the old 50cc motor that I rebuilt. That was a junkyard motor. I got about, 4,000 some miles on that one.
She served herself.
Yeah.
Time for an upgrade.
Yep.
Yeah.
Speed upgrade. Now I heard that what's his name? Olin made his own Avenger 85 MZ65 pipes.
So you're thinking about that now, huh?
Yeah. Performance.
Yeah.
Bigger motor, more power, and different style pipe.
Different style pipe. You don't have an expansion chamber on any of your bikes, do you?
No. I could use that Phantom pipe I got and rig it for one of them MZ65 pipes for the expansion chamber on the end. I was thinking about putting it on a 4-stroke. I was like, nah, I might save it for my Avenger build for the Green Mongoose.
But your Super Menace has a nice pipe on him, doesn't it?
The old stock 85 Phantom pipe.
Which I thought was one of super cool pipes out there. It's loud as hell.
You can hear that much. You can hear that motherfucker come down the street.
How far?
20 miles. You can hear
2 or 3 miles. You think
about a mile? About a mile. You can hear that. Yeah, you can hear that motherfucker come down the street.
You can hear that motherfucker come down the street. Ah, was that when she was test riding? You heard that motherfucker? That was a good sound effect.
I was like, damn, is that what my bike sounds like? Holy shit, I'm out fucking loud. Yeah, Smolik, I ain't hating on him. He Smolik knows his shit on performance parts.
DNA said he's going to post a video. Right here, this is really cool. I get a chance to promote it for him.
It's just some of his
shit. We'll leave that up for a few minutes.
It's just that some of his stuff that he builds, it's little overpriced.
Who?
Smolik. He's got a Avenger 85. Yeah, he's got this Avenger 85 motor with a CNC case, and he wants that whole motor for $900. It's got a racing head on it, CNC engine case, and a different CDI coil startup thing. He wants $900.
And you think about it sometimes, don't you?
Yeah, I'm thinking about buying it, but no.
I
don't got that kind of money.
Think about it. I do think about it.
I would like to get it, though. Because Leonard's hating on us because we're still buying from the Chinese and we got to buy stuff that's made in America and shit.
I checked out Kim's Scrambler. You see that? Yeah, you see Kiss Grammar there?
He says he's got one of those pipes. All he has to do is build a bike around it.
Look, he come up too because he's like, he's learning. He's learning, and I'm gonna tell him he's learning.
Yeah.
He's like, I need a follower. But
if I do put one of them big performance pipes on my bike, I'm gonna buy some piping wrap so my leg don't get cooked like a piece of bacon.
Hey, if you check out a Skeptical Force, he had made a heat shield on the side of his out of the chain tensioner guard. You know, the chain guard that they send in every kit. Yep, he shows you where he made a heat shield out of that piece of metal.
So, yeah, I've seen that. Kind of
cool. It looks super fucking cool in that way. They're like, oh, there's that thing you can do with it. Perfect.
Jason says he bought one of them Smolik heads for $50. Was it the Phantom 85 cylinder with the chop top service? Because if it was, I'll tell you what parts you use to make that motor work to where it no longer snags the piston rings. I'm waiting to see if he comments back.
I got 4 minutes. I got 4 minutes. Four of them? Is that Dancing Bear? I can't see his little pink thing, our little baby teal.
All right.
Yep. Was that for us? He's getting more savvy, guys. Look at that. Look at that. He's like, I've got a thing. Very cool. I'm being quiet for him, like I was about to blow his cover or something. Right? I mean, shit. And here, check this out, guys. If he turns his volume all the way down when I'm talking, he can still hear me. He can't turn us up. But if I turn my volume all the way down while he's talking, I can still hear him too. I can't cut him off. I can only mute. He can mute me, and I can mute him back. But we can't. You can't turn the volume all the way down enough where it's off. And I think that was some people who have tried to jump on this. Michael Brinks, dude, we're on the trip, dude. Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Called it right off. Ah, he's gone. Yes, Michael Brinks, guy. He's one of the great commenters. I don't remember if he does have a channel or not, but I think I'm subscribed to him anyways. And he'd poked me a bunch of times about having trips and stuff and doing different adventures. And he kept saying, "Let's all get together and head over to the God damn it, the rally, Sturgis, fucking Sturgis." He's like, "Man, fucking you guys, let's all get together and fuck Sturgis, man. Stop being a bunch of punks." Anyway, it's all just a bunch of fucking still. We should, though. We wanted to mob all up in there. You know, little fucking mob. I don't know. Bring some first ups. Set up some first ups, man. There, we got first up. We're here. They bite ghosts fast. Do I just, post long, stupid, rambling comments? No, you don't, dude. Everybody, I do. No, I read your... Dude, anytime I find your comment, even... I always read your damn comment, dude. I go on. The comment section. Find your ass down in the comment section. I almost fell off the bucket.
Believe that.
Jason Burke says he has the 460. And Raul's going to come in here and say goodnight with us. He's moved to an even more. What's going on here? An even more safer location.
Nah, sorry about that. Anyway, what you use is when you buy the Menace 85 cylinder from Smolik, he gives you a MS460 piston with the holes already drilled out for the reed valve holes. And then it comes with the stock MS460 piston rings. Yeah. You throw them bitches away and you go on eBay and you look up Caber piston rings, HWY, 52 millimeter, and then you force them onto that piston.
You have kept up with Mike Miller's Phantom, though, have you? Did you roll?
Yeah, I do believe he's using a chainsaw, what is it, an MS-440 big bore?
He says, my Phantom experiment version 2 has 1,500 miles and still runs great. But I believe he did a few modifications at purchase from everybody telling, you know, what was breaking, and he cured it before it had a chance to do it so far. But he cured it, I think.
Yeah, listen, my motor, it can't overheat because of that big fucking head from Olin cools the engine down a lot faster. And it starts up a lot quicker. Before, usually when you first get the motor, you got to leave the carburetor on choke. And then as you drive and get a little bit of throttle, you got to push the choke lever down.
He says that he got the ideas for the modifications for BRT.
Everyone should try out my modification because the Caber piston rings with the MS 460 pistons with the Caber piston rings, that bitch works. Hasn't failed yet. And let's see. That thing's still running too.
It says I, Raul.
Yeah. There you go. Comment back on that. Yeah, you're talking about a coated piston. I'm talking about the Phantom version 1, 2, and 3 has overheating problems. I solved it with the chop top service with the head, that big fucking head from Olin. Oh, and 2 LD100 copper head gaskets. See, because the LD100, the YD100, the newer ones, they match up with the Phantom on the bolt spacing. Yep. Yeah, he was right. 52 millimeter MS 440 big bore piston and rings. Yep. I do believe that is the chainsaw head modification. My question is, are you using the JB weld or are you using the JB weld with copper gaskets at the bottom?
What, seal it?
Yeah. Because I noticed the ERT tried to do that and the gas seeped through and it ate the JB weld right out.
Probably should try silicone next, huh?
Yeah. I don't think he let it cure enough overnight. You gotta wait until that shit like dries out and turns into like
concrete. Which isn't overnight, dude. It takes a good full 24 hours or more to become this nice standable stuff, and you'll tell that it is totally different than it was fucking 8 hours ago. It's not, and it'll make this fine dust when you stand it. You're like, oh no, it's dry through and through now. It is a much better bond than it was any other time before.
I seen some people, they'll use the marine grade shit JB Weld are the ones where it's like so resistant to gas that it doesn't even affect it.
Yeah.
Most people go with that very high temperature JB Weld.
Well, I really appreciate you coming on with me this evening, Raul, just for a few. Did you get a damn notification?
You popped up on YouTube. It said when you were live.
Oh, so I did. Yeah. So, well, Christy put hers in there. She said no. DNS said no. Several of them said no. I don't know. I don't know why. I wonder how I can fix that. I don't know what I can do to fix that. They were here anyways, only because they fucking naturally checked. I'm sure that's the only thing in that way, you know. But
well, if you look at the actual Phantom 85 cylinder head, they cut that top fin off where the spark plug twists in. That's the part of the head that you cut off. And then you do a build break fix, get some sandpaper. I forget which grit you get. Put the sandpaper down on the table, take that top of the cylinder head and slowly go back and forth and get it to where the head will match up. Now that's the thing. It's the
sorry about that guy that way.
Yeah, the CNC head's from Olin, so it matches up to the Phantom, so the piston works. I didn't have to modify that or nothing.
Okay, well, I'm just talking anyways. I want to thank everybody who joined us this evening, you two as well, Raul, and thanks a lot. I it's 10:05, and I gotta get this. See you tomorrow night if you'd like to, you know. I'll have more of this worked out, you know. I'll probably do personal for at least an hour long though, and but maybe we'll do a second hour and then tomorrow. Right? Like, yeah, I'm gonna try to do the vertical thing tomorrow though. We're gonna try something different.
Stuff up. You're talking to Nicole. Hell no.
You said mom.